They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
They have taken crafty counsel against who?
Thy people.
Y'all see that? What we're reading here is conspiracy. Crafty means they're not going to come out and say, I hate your guts, you Negroes and Latinos.
The condition that we live in is the result of someone's thinking.
People sit back and think about things like that. Look up the definition of genocide. I'm gonna just backtrack. Last week we discussed suicide and homicide somewhat thoroughly. I rushed through genocide, so I want to go through that briefly. Genocide, the deliberate killing of a large group of people, especially those of a particular ethnic group or nation. Abiel, do me a favor. I want you to look up, I believe it's on YouTube, Bill Gates did an interview about population control. Thank you. Just find me that. It shouldn't be too long.
Over 26 billion tons. For each American, it's about 20 tons. For people in poor countries, it's less than one ton. It's an average of about 5 tons for everyone on the planet. And somehow we have to make changes that will bring that down to zero. It's been constantly going up. It's only various economic changes that have even flattened it at all. So we have to go from rapidly rising to falling and falling all the way to zero. This equation has 4 factors, a little bit of multiplication. So you've got a thing on the left, CO2, that you want to get to zero. And that's going to be based on the number of people, the services each person's using on average, the energy on average for each service, and the CO2 being put out per unit of energy. So let's look at each one of these and see how we can get this down to zero. Probably one of these numbers is going to have to get pretty near to zero. That's back from high school algebra. But let's take a look. First, we've got population. The world today has 6.8 billion people. That's headed up to about 9 billion. Now, if we do a really great job on new vaccines, healthcare, reproductive health services, we could lower that by perhaps 10 or 15%. But there we see an increase of about 1.3.
Y'all see that? So he admits vaccines will reduce population by 15%. Not just vaccines, he said. Reproductive services, Planned Parenthood. What else did he say? Healthcare. So y'all know who Bill Gates is. He is the co-founder of Microsoft. And everybody, most black and Latino people believe that Bill Gates helped create Microsoft to benefit black and Latino people. Incorrect. He could care less about black and Latino. In fact, his grandparents were involved in the, his father was involved in a eugenics program. Can we pull up the eugenics tree? So Bill Gates, the philanthropist, everyone loves him. Black people, Spanish people, Latin people, Indian people. But he is introducing things not to reduce white population, but to reduce our population.
Maybe, what did you say? He's a what? He's a what? A for what?
A philanthropist.
Philanthropist. Philanthropist.
You know, he gives.
Yeah,
he,
of course. Oh, cool. Oh. How many of y'all know what that term means, philanthropy? Like we're talking about philanthropic institutions and so forth. Who doesn't know what it means? Well, I'm going to read it from here. It says a person who seeks to promote the welfare of others, especially by the generous donation of money to good causes. So how in the world does this correlate with the man that just spoke eugenics out of his mouth? Go ahead, Bishop.
So, Bill Gates, whose father was one of the people involved in the eugenics program, now he comes out that the world population, we're at what? He says 6 billion going towards 9? He said we have to reduce that. Right.
Then he gave the means on how the reduction is made.
He said vaccines.
He said vaccines.
Healthcare.
Birth control.
And what else did he say? Something services.
Reproductive services.
That's where they got those, the pill. They got those little, what's those things the women put on their arms and say so they don't get pregnant? The patch. Mm-hmm. A death patch. Yeah, and they catch a stroke and drop dead. All these things fall under that. So this man does not love our people at all. Because there's another part where they show the whole thing. He said, let's start in Africa. Mm-hmm. He said, particularly West Africa. So you got to sit back and go, well, what is he talking about doing? And in those places, Ebola rose. You had the Zika. Well, Zika, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's South America. You got AIDS, right? AIDS, Ebola hit the plague. Bam! Shazam over there. Here come Bill Gates. I love black people. Let me give you a vaccine.
He's a philanthropist.
He's a philanthropist.
He's a philanthropist for good causes.
Bill Gates, I was watching something. He got a few things in Africa. He go to Africa every year, two, three times. He got big money invested in Africa.
Exactly. Not real. Our people are so gullible. We just see a smiling white man who says he loves us, but meanwhile, all is deceit. Okay. What are you going to say?
How many of y'all are familiar with what is known as infertilization clinics in places like that? Raise your hands up high so I can see. Women? Okay. The majority, because where I work, I see the majority of these kinds of things. And the majority of the people that go to these places are white folks because of their inability to reproduce. They go in there and they learn and they get whatever they need to get to help them have
science.
Twins, yeah, twins and all that, quadruplets, the whole nine. Yeah. And whenever they have a baby, the whole family is rejoicing. They're going crazy over it. Because they want to increase the population growth among them. So this stuff that Bill Gates is talking about is not aimed at white people. That's my point.
Right.
It's only for us. That's what this is what I see. Okay? But on the other side, like some of the brothers here that were saying that when they go to the hospitals and have their babies, the doctors come into the rooms right away and start telling them they can't have any more kids, stuff right. like that, and start giving them all kinds of pamphlets and this and that and the other, stop this, stop that. They don't do that with Edomites.
Exactly. Exactly. Now, get me a Wikipedia and look up what we looked up last week about genocide conspiracy. I always tell y'all I'm not keen on conspiracies because conspiracies generally you cannot change or alter. Is that it? Okay, we're going to look up genocide. Go to the top. Genocide. So, there are plots against our people. Plots. I'm going to tell you right now, the only thing that can save us from these plots is the Most High. I remember. How many of y'all heard of think tanks? Think tanks. See, good. We did a video on it in Atlanta, where America, and not just America, many all countries haven't, but particularly America has made. Can you look up think tanks for us? A lot of y'all don't know what these think tanks are involved in. Think tanks, Captain Isaac, get me Psalms 83 and 4. Read this for us. Right. Let's start at verse 2. I'm going to show you something. Yeah, read that. Just read that for me.
The book of Psalms, chapter 83 and verse 4. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
Read the verse above it.
For lo, thine enemies make a tumult.
The enemies are the nations of the world. They make a tumult, a noisy gathering. Go ahead.
And they that hate thee.
The nations that hate thee.
Have lifted up the head.
Go ahead.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
They have taken crafty counsel against who?
Thy people.
Y'all see that? What we're reading here is conspiracy. They have taken crafty counsel. Let me say it slow in case I stutter. Crafty counsel is conspiracy. Crafty means they're not going to come out and say, I hate your guts, you Negroes and Latinos. They're crafty and say, we love you. Take this medicine. It will heal you. I wanted to mention that. You got doctors in Nigeria scientists in Nigeria, got many African nations, even in South America. The white man comes with a vaccine from America and says, inject your people with this. You mean there's not one African scientist or one Latino scientist that can say, before you inject my people, let me examine the contents of this? And not just one, because the first 100 might be good, might be decent. But it's the other 1,000 that might got poison in it. Time-release poison. I'll give you an example of what I'm talking about. Y'all know what I'm talking about. They got commercials about time-release poison called shingles. Yes, sir. They said if you got the chicken pox vaccine back when you – I got it when I was 5. Mm-hmm. They said chances are when you reach – late 40s, early 50s, you may develop something called shingles. And the reason they're doing commercials on it, because white folks getting it. You see how God do them? What they meant for evil, God said, okay, you meant that for evil for my people. I'm going to turn that whole clock on you, red behind. Now, Shazam, you got shingles. All the white people, we got shingles. We got shingles. It wasn't supposed to affect us.
Yeah.
Now, how many of y'all seen the movie Three the Hard Way? Only, you got to be up in age to see that. But it's a what they call black exploitation movie. Anyway, in the movie, it ain't black exploitation. Stop them words. Esau and these words. In the movie, they're trying to develop a vaccine to kill black people. But they said the problem was making it racially specific. So in the movie, they had finally come up with it. And then you had my man Jim Brown,
kicking ass.
Jim Kelly was kicking butt. And Fred Williamson, whooping white. See, I like the movies.
I got that movie.
That was so rare to see black people just beating white folks up. They said that's not right. It's called black exploitation. You're exploiting black people. No, that used to invigorate us. We'll smack you down. Go ahead, try something. We used to love that stuff when I was little. But anyway, you got what did I ask for? Think tanks, thank you. Okay, a think tank. A think tank or policy institute, research institute, etc., is an organization that performs research and advocacy concerning topics. Listen to the topics a think tank deals with, such as social policy, political strategy, economics, military, technology, and culture. I want y'all to see, you may think that, look at that and go, so I don't get it. Can you read Psalms 83 one more again for us?
Psalms 83 and verse 2. For lo, thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
Crafty counsel. Let's look at culture. You may say, why do you need a think tank about culture? Okay, there's a couple of things that deal with culture when it comes to a thing. A think tank, they don't just get any idiot off the street. A think tank, they will go to such schools as Oxford, Yale, Harvard, universities, and look for the most elite students, white students. And if there is a black or Latin one in there, they say, we need their input. So they'll get in, let's say they're getting, this day is 30 of them. They say, listen, we need something, a think tank, we will pay you, let's say, $400,000 a year to come up with a cultural way to, of course, keep white society on top. They won't say white, they may say keep America going and keep the urban element down. Somebody will sit back and go, they'll sit there and say, what can we do? Somebody will go, and they go, okay, you. Music. So, music. How can we keep America going and keep urban communities down with music? Well, Negroes love music, and what they do is they like to dance a lot. So why don't you hire some of the most illiterate black people you can find and rap about murder, rape, drug dealing? This will keep white society privileged and black people down. And they go, yeah. Has it worked? Oh, you better believe it has. Culture, the way women dress. Let's have them create mannequins. I went through Washington Heights. Look at the mannequins in Washington Heights and look at the mannequins in Macy's on 34th. Two different mannequins. The mannequins in Macy's will not be so developed and it will be somewhat modest. Go to Spanish Harlem, Washington Heights. The mannequins got a big butt. The jeans will come down on the mannequin and you'll see the crack of the mannequin. I'm like, what the hell is this? Women walk by and go, I could look like that. These are little things. Now, I'm just bringing up little things, but that's people sit back and think about things like that. Holidays, Easter. We need to keep them involved in Easter. There's a new commercial with Easter where you have a black family, black women cheering and a kid's running around. I love Easter. I think it's Target, if I'm not mistaken. It's a new commercial. Huh? Walmart? Walmart. Right, it's a whole Jake family, because usually they only put Jake families on McDonald's. But now with Walmart, it's promoting Easter. And that is a think tank to keep us in that state of mind. Then go back to what we were looking at. That's not what I was looking at before. Think tank, where is it? Okay. Notice there's a think tank for economics. You may say this, so how do you have a think tank on that? That thing, there's so much involved in economics. Send blacks and Latinos to school. How's that going to affect them economically? Have them be the workers. We need them to be the wage slave workers. We don't need them to be the entrepreneurs or the CEOs of their own companies. We need them to do the groundwork. Just go out and do the lowest menial labor work. Don't teach them about budgets. Don't teach them about balancing checkbooks. Don't teach them about credit. Don't teach them that stuff. That's all involved a think tank. That's why, like, when I was in junior high, there was something called economics. There was a class called economics,
home economics.
And they taught credit. Mm-hmm. They taught carpentry. They taught things that little basic things you could use to get a job if you didn't want to go to college. Plumbing, mm-hmm. all of trade. Thank you. That's right. What they pulled all that out to school. They said, no, because they're opening up their own businesses. Stop that. And you went, I'm like, how come? I'm asking my kids, y'all got home economics? What's that? Nobody knows about that no more, but we had it when we was kids. You had that? They took all that. There was a think tank behind all that. A group of people sitting down, having conversations, not just any people, smart people. Yes, Lama.
Yeah, Bishop, with economic, you notice that that's what Howard's Wife is about. These shows, they're showing you black women dressing the most expensive with things that went that don't belong to them. They're showing you cars. They're showing you everything. With these thinkers, what they tell the people, they say, we need the black people just to buy, not to think, just the buyer. That's what you have to put in their mind, just to buy. That's why when you go to even though the thing we get every the end of the year, when you looking at the income tax a month, you see Walmart, there is no place to park. You see Target, there is no place to park. You see any avenues where they can keep our people just to spend, because if we stop spending, we will create a different cycle. Because, like you said, we will develop within ourselves things that we need for our people. But as long that we spend the money in the white America, that got to do with the economy. They teach us how to spend. They don't teach us how to reframe ourselves from spending. Then we can heal our own self. They don't teach us that.
I'm going to say, can I say something real quick? On the topic of economics and the think tank around that, could he go to something I was looking up? Abia, who's ever on the set here, look up the Green Book. I'm going to show you how the think tank revolves around the changing of thinking when it comes to economics. That's it. See that thing there? Right. The Negro Motorist Green Book. How many of you have heard of that? Nobody. Nobody, nobody in here? This right here was a book that was given, so you remember, you know about this. Right, this was a book that was given f- for motorists black during the Jim Crow era to where as we travel the highways, we would have places where we can get gas, sleep, those kinds of things. And these were all businesses that were catered to black people. What kind of thinking did it take to get us off of this kind of thinking where this is not even a thought anymore? And we're not even upset. That takes some crafty thinking to the point where you didn't even, this is foreign material to us. And this was decades ago. Now, we don't even think about it. You go driving gas, you might pull over to get some gas and a redneck be in the doggone place. It would never cross your mind. You know what? We used to have places where we could sleep, get gas, get something to eat. Touch and such. You don't have that anymore. And nobody's even thinking about what we have, where we fell from. And we are comfortable in being the way we are.
Exactly. Go back to Think Tank again. Now, social policy, that was another one. See, it's a social policy. When you look that up, it deals with, like, welfare states or whatever, like how they deal with giving monies. Somebody sat back and said, you know what, with this thing, we can destroy their families. Let's give these women some money, free housing, as long as they ain't got no man up in there. Somebody sat down and thought about this thing.
Bishop, I don't think the people believe what we're bringing out.
They don't believe.
They don't believe this because they just can't be this cruel.
They can't.
They just can't be this vindictive and diabolical and evil. They cannot be this way. No. Yes. Look, the condition that we live in is the result of someone's thinking.
Exactly. Here's another one. Remember how the push was for black people to be Democrats? Democratic is the way for black people. If you notice now, there's a shift, and they're saying democracy, the democratic process does not work. Let's be Republicans. And you got a lot of, they look and found some black people that say Republicanism is the way to go. Somebody sat back and thought about that and paid these Negroes some money to push this campaign. So what I'm showing you, America, this country has thousands of think tanks where they hire the smartest people. And the foundation, I want to read it one more time. Don't think it's to make us rise up in society. Read that again, Captain. Psalms 83.
Psalms 83 and verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
Now, if you think that's not true, with all these smartest people in the world, none of them figured out the way the Israelites. None of them figured out the way so that blacks can own their own companies. None of them figured out. That's not their job for us to succeed in society. Their job is for us to be wage slave earners to support the system. Give me that scripture in Sirach. I think it's chapter 39. You know what I want? It says these maintain the state of the world. That one.
Sirach 38.
38. Thank you.
Verse.
It's the last verse.
Verse 34.
Okay.
But they will maintain the state of the world, and all their desire is in the work of their craft.
That's how they train us up to be, to maintain the state of the world. The world at that time was Rome, Greco-Roman Empire. Now it's the United States of America. We're not meant to succeed and to rule and or dominate, but to work and support, okay? From there, give me the next video on COINTELPRO. Now you may ask yourself, what has COINTELPRO got to do with genocide? It has a lot of things to do with genocide. I'm going to show you something about, now we all Israelites, I'll talk about myself, we give Martin Luther King a hard rap. We give him a bad rap. Hell, God gives him a bad rap. But with the white man's think tanks, Martin Luther King said, I'm going to go nonviolent. That is the way to go. But because he was so, give me the word, when his personality, the way he spoke, he was able to, charismatic, thank you. He was so charismatic, he was still a threat to white society. Now, I want to start at 2 minutes and 38 seconds. I want y'all to, this is a meeting in Congress about Martin Luther King and many black leaders. Now, the part we're going to look at is dealing with Martin Luther King. Now, that's J. Edgar Hoover, the demon head of the FBI. This demon right here, I'll tell you, that dude's a demon. right there.
He's a think tank within himself.
When we get the kingdom, Lord, can I have him? I want that one right there. It's that one. We had 2 minutes, 38 seconds. Okay, let's start. Just listen good.
This movement was also subjected to heavy attack by Hoover. Billions of government dollars were spent in this direction. Many of these activities were not only unwarranted, but of questionable legality. The congressional hearings into the assassination of Dr. King bore this out. Two FBI agents testified before a Senate committee chaired by Senator Frank Church.
I'm trying to find out what it was that impelled some part of the FBI to pursue Martin Luther King with such an obsession. And what I understood that answer to be is, first of all, it was not any suspicions of the commission of a federal crime. None of the literature showed up a single suggestion that Martin Luther King had committed or was about to commit a crime. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Yes, sir, but at this point, much of what was being done did involve challenges to local laws. And there is a very strong suggestion that King was seen as rallying the lawbreakers and would-be lawbreakers, albeit for a cause that sounded pure. I'm looking now in terms of, if we look at what might have gotten the Bureau started, and if we remember at the same time he is extremely critical of the Bureau's own law enforcement efforts, and we see throughout these documents and the new left documents that it is taboo to criticize the Bureau, right, and particularly the director.
Well, was he ever charged with fomenting violence? Did he ever participate in violence? Was it ever alleged that he was about to be violent?
That was the very opposite of his philosophy, Senator.
So that it was neither the fear of commission of a crime or the commission of violence. Was there any serious charge that he himself was a communist?
No such charge ever was made.
So that what was left then was a decision on the part of some persons or person within the FBI that he should nevertheless be pursued
and replaced.
And the basis for that.
Stop. Y'all missed it. Played it out. Just go back like a few seconds. Listen to the response to what he says.
On the part of some persons or person within the FBI that he should nevertheless be pursued
and replaced.
And the base.
Stop. Did y'all hear what he said? And replaced. Now, they're going to get into it a little more about that replace. But the dude threw that in there. Their job was to neutralize him and replace him. That makes you go, replace him? What do you mean replace him? Play on.
The basis for that apparently was political. The decision that he was dangerous or potentially dangerous to someone's notion of what this country should be doing, and a further theory that the FBI possessed the ability to enter into this field and to investigate and to intimidate and seek to neutralize and indeed replace a civil rights leader that they thought to be politically unacceptable. Is that correct?
Yes. To what? Neutralize. Neutralize, I mean kill you. Kill you and replace you. You might ask, what has that got to do with genocide? I'm going to give you a scripture and I'm going to see who's thinking. Give me Proverbs 29:18. We always read this one. I'm going to see who can connect the dots. Why kill? If Martin Luther King was no threat to nobody with his nonviolence, why take him out?
The book of Proverbs, chapter 29, verse 18. Where there is no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he.
Now read the first part. All I want is the first precept.
Where there is no vision, the people perish.
Stop. Who can connect the dots? Why was Martin Luther King assassinated, neutralized? And you know what? Go ahead. Get a lie. Let me hear you.
Because he was so charismatic that whatever with his visions, the people would follow it, which he changed his vision when he said that he fears that he had integrated his people to a burning house.
Right.
So right before he changed his mind and people were to follow him, they neutralized him.
Exactly. They said, well, he ain't doing it yet, but the potential. is there. They say, kill him. Kill the, what is that expression, kill a messenger? I can't quote. What is it? You got to kill a messenger, you kill the, how does
you kill
it
everybody behind him.
Kill the head and the body. Okay, something yeah, like that. Like, or smite the shepherd and the right, sheep will scatter. I'll use that one. I know that one. Yeah. So get rid of Martin Luther King and all the people will, that vision will be, it'll pass. Everybody forget about it. Then they said to replace him. When y'all watch the video, you can watch the rest on your own. You see Ralph Abernathy pop up in the meeting. Jesse Jackson pop up in the meeting. Al Sharpton pop up in the meeting. Oh, so I'm saying, I'm watching. I said, now I wonder who was their man to replace him. Now, the same thing, when you read on this whole thing, they mentioned Malcolm. They said neutralize him and replace him. And I had to sit back and I'm like, replace him. They already have people set up who's in their pockets that say, listen, you are going to do A, B, and C. You get the phone call. Ring, ring, ring.
Yeah, Bishop, yeah. With Dr. King, his influence, the white man is looking to their influence. He have a lot of people following him. He say, we cannot take the chance. If he turn, he already have influence. People going to follow him. Let's take him out now. That when you're looking at the times that they have to take that man out, his influence was big on black people.
Right.
They have C's influence.
I watched the video yesterday. I sit back and watch videos. Where he had the meeting with Malcolm X. When Malcolm created the, what's the organization made? When he left the Black Muslim Movement? No, he didn't make that. No. It was United something, Negro. I can't remember the acronym, but it was something. Him and King, and their plan was for King to deal with the people in the South, and Malcolm said he would take the North because Malcolm had more success in the North, and Martin had more success in the South. So that's when, right after that meeting, Malcolm was killed, and they said, well, King ain't done nothing yet, but the potential is there. Take him out. So you may be saying to yourself, what does that have to do with us today? What are you going to say?
They don't believe what... I know y'all still struggling about the thing about being charismatic. Charismatic. I don't know why I can't say the word, but I... How many of you that work on your particular jobs, either you yourself are like this or you know people at your job that have that seem to have the ability to draw people to them? But here's my point. Well, I did ask y'all first. I had a whole sea of people that agree with me because they do it themselves. My point is that it gets white folks' attention. It gets the boss' attention. Till y'all notice that. If y'all have that kind of spirit where people are drawn to you, that makes these people nervous. They said because he has the ability, even though you haven't said anything, you have the ability to lead masses of people. And they are quick to pick that up.
And what they need to realize, what they do realize with these think tanks, let me tell you something. They have, oh, you know what I forgot to look up? With the think tanks, just to let you know, they have Bible think tanks. Mm-hmm. People that are paid, that's their job. Your job is to study that Bible. And you let us know any secrets you find in it and how it relates to the people. That's their job. That's all they do. Get paid $500,000, maybe more, a year. I'm going to show you that. In the book of Psalms, it talks about that. Just remind me later on. Give me Exodus 1:15. We went over this last week, but I just want to touch on it again. Exodus 1:15 and 16. I know I did quite a bit of talking. I don't like talking so much. I want to read scriptures.
Exodus chapter 1 and verse 16.
15 and 16.
Verse 15. And the king of Egypt spake to the Hebrew midwives, of which the name of the one was Shiphrah, and the name of the other, Puah. And he said, when ye do the office of a midwife to the Hebrew women, and see them upon the stools, if it be a son, then ye shall kill him. But if it be a daughter, then she shall live.
So that's what's called a conspiracy. That is a conspiracy of a military in mighty people against a poor people, which was us, and we had no might against it. The Most High had the spirit on those sisters, Shiphrah and Puah, who used their influence. Listen good to what I'm saying. Use their influence among, remember, This, you talk about millions of Israelites. All those two women couldn't deal with all the women. Those were the senior women that instructed all the other women. When you have a boy, and when you read the whole thing, and Pharaoh called those two sisters before him, they had to stomach it up. They had to, for lack of better words, man up. You may say, jump down to verse 22, Captain.
Verse 22. And Pharaoh charged all his people, saying, every son that is born ye shall cast into the river, and every daughter ye shall save alive.
So they were killing all of the boy kids. That's a conspiracy against it. Why? Because they knew a savior, a deliverer, was prophesied to come. How did they know that? Because they were reading our records. The records, the few records we had, they said, and Josephus said they were looking at the stars, and they said there's a deliverer prophesied to come. And they said, when you read in Josephus, it tells you that the baby Moses came in and kicked Pharaoh's staff. And they said, that's going to be the boy. Some of them knew that was going to be the boy. But anyway, go from there. Get me Matthew 2 and 16. We went over this last week. I just want to touch on a few things. Bear with me. I'm about to change it. Focus in a second. I just want to rehash this again.
Matthew 2, verse 16.
16 through 18.
Then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked of the wise men, was exceeding wroth, and sent forth and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and in all the coasts thereof, from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently inquired of the wise men.
So, this lets you know that Herod, he wasn't no dummy. A lot of times we look at these presidents, governors, congressmen, senators. These are not dummies sitting around. They have people who are in their pocket that are think tanks, who are hired to know a little bit about everything. We don't have no think tanks, blacks and Latinos. And if you see one, it's garbage. I'm telling you, I Googled black think tanks, and I looked through us. These are some real dummies up in here. These are not think tanks. Yeah, we need a dollar. And with the dollar, we can make a dream. I'm like, oh, shut up.
What is the purpose of a think tank? Like you mentioned, you've checked out black think tanks. What is the purpose of a think tank? Huh? Brainstorm what? That's not an answer. What is the purpose of why would you form a think tank? Okay, what did he say? Yeah, he said something more heavier. Put it in the microphone. I want y'all to think. I don't want to take the bishop from his class.
Yeah, shalom. For creative upliftment, growth, for building, and for motivation and growing, and also confident in people.
Okay. Now, you said a whole lot there, but I can rest with that. I'm going to give it back to the bishop. But let me just surmise it by saying this here. The purpose of a think tank, you have to have a particular program in your mind, and you have to have a thought as to where you want, as you wait, if you're thinking in terms of a people, you have to have in your mind the end result in your mind in order for you to think of ways on getting it. And the think tank is a body of people where they run a series of ideas through, I guess, a gauntlet of scrutiny with all of the people that are there to see if how viable it is to survive, to see if it can actually come to fruition. Y'all understand what I'm saying? It's a whole series of ideas. Okay, well, if we do this here, how many things will strike against it? And they run it through, and they throw ideas at it. Okay, that's not going to survive, so we're not going to use that. So they'll come up with something else until it passed through everybody. Then they say, you know what? This one survived our scrutiny test. This is what we're going to roll with. And that's how they did us. Everything that they've programmed and they got out here, they ran it through a series of think tanks which involved leaders, religious persons of charismatic ability. They've tested it all against it. They said, well, will this survive a person like so-and-so? They said, okay, run it. Okay, it'll pass that. Will it run past this? Once they got that whole thing together, they all agree with it and find a way to saturate the people's minds with it through television and music and the rest of it. Y'all all right?
Exactly.
Bishop?
It's all, Officer Renan sent this to me. This is correct. Theos. Theos is a Christian think tank, which believes you can't understand the modern world without understanding religion. So this is another think tank. Now, I'm going to give you another think tank. religious one called National Council of Churches. We've discussed that back in the day, remember? Where they're the ones that sat down and said, this is how you teach John 3:16. This is what it means. And they sent all, in order to be a member of that, you got to have a congregation of no less than, what was it? I think it was a million, something like that. It was a big number, though, you had to have to be a part of it. They're the ones that sit down and explain what the interpretation of Scripture is. That's why all these ministers, if you notice, how they all manage to teach the same garbage the same way. Like about Christmas. Not one of them sat down, because they all went to theology school. They read Jeremiah 10, 1 through 4, 5, about, what does it say? Learn not the ways of the heathen. That you learn that in theology school. One of their books is The Two Babylons by Hyslop, Alexander Hyslop, where he goes through the history of Christmas. But when they're sent out under the National Council of Churches, they are all teaching Christmas. Jesus was born December 25th. That's all a think tank. That's not by accident, because ain't nobody all that. Everyone's not stupid. It's by creative, crafty design. Everybody understand what I'm saying? Crafty, creative design. Did you finish that, Captain Isaac?
No, sir.
Come on.
Verse 17. Then was fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremy the prophet.
Jeremy the prophet is Jeremiah. Go ahead.
In Ramah was there a voice heard, lamentation and weeping and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children and would not be comforted because they are not.
Because they are not, because they were being killed. The children were being killed. Now, get me Revelation 7, verse 4. You mean to tell me these think tanks never read this stuff? They've read it. They've read it. You can, and they know you cannot understand the world. Like we just read, go back to that Theos thing real quick, that sentence. Theos is a Christian think tank. Well, listen good. Which believes you can't understand the modern world without understanding religion, meaning the Bible. They are hired, paid big dollars to study this book to deal with the modern world. What does that mean? Prophecies. This is what's going to happen. Now watch this. Revelation 7
and
4.
Revelation 7 and 4. And I heard the number of them which were sealed.
Start at 3 for me.
Verse 3. Saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads.
So Christ is saying, hold back the thermonuclear destruction until the servants of God are sealed in their minds. Go ahead.
And I heard the number of them which were sealed, and there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of the children of Israel.
Y'all see that? Now let's see what they're going to be sealed with. Get that now, Isaiah 8:16, please. The sealing. What are they to be sealed with? I'm going to show you what Theos and the National Council of Churches know that the rest of our people don't know.
Isaiah 8:16. Bind up the testimony. Seal the law among my disciples.
Bind up the testimony and seal the law among my disciples. Now get me Hebrews 8 and 10. I think that's it.
Hebrews 8 and 10. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their mind.
See that? I will put my laws into their mind. So when Revelation talked about seal them in their foreheads, it's still talking about sealing the servants of God with the law in their brain. You don't think Theos knows that? You don't think National Council of Churches know these prophecies? Abortion clinics is not a coincidence. It is the same thing we read in Exodus chapter 1. It is the same thing we read in Matthew chapter 2. They said a savior, saviors are coming. Wait, they don't know. They don't know. Give me that. Hold that. Give me Obadiah. I'm going to show you another word for the 144,000 in the book of Obadiah. The last verse, I think it is. Isaac,
do you have it? Obadiah, verse 21. And saviors shall come up on Mount Zion to judge the Mount of Esau.
The 144,000 are called saviors. So when Egypt knew a savior was coming, they said, kill the children. When Rome knew a savior was coming, kill the children. America knows saviors are coming.
There you go.
Abortion clinics, Ebola, Zika. It's all the same craftiness. Go ahead, y'all, what's up?
Now, You said something earlier, but I got you. Don't worry. You're going to be all right. You mentioned prophecies in the Bible and the World Council of and the World and the National Council of Churches. They study prophecies like we just saw up on the screen. They actually have think tanks set aside to go through the prophecies of the Bible. Remember what I was telling you about the purpose of think tanks and what they do. They run ideas through gauntlets. Well, they run these prophecies through gauntlets. They're reading about like what you just read there. Read that again, Captain.
And saviors.
I'm approved of. Just listen. Go ahead.
And saviors shall come up on Mount Zion.
Just like what you just said, Egypt, they said a savior's coming. We got to take care of that. Kill him. Rome, the same thing. Kill him before they get here. Well, they're thinking the same thing here because this right here is a prophecy that is in effect now, that's coming up now. So this is not during the time of Rome. This is not during the time of Egypt. Y'all all right? We're in this time now. So their think tanks is designed to look at scriptures like this here, prophecies like this here, and to do exactly what you just said. What are we going to do to offset the understanding that these people are going to bring saviors to save their nation? What are we going to do? Abortion clinics, churches, mess their minds up with white Christ, all the rest of it. All kinds of evil and all kinds of things are being pushed out here to cause you to be twisted in your thoughts when it comes to these prophecies.
You know, Deacon Yalzop, you know, when you meditate within the things that they have put on our people to be the sin. Anytime you trying to come, white man don't give you money. He don't let you be leader over your people to show your people how to think. That's not what he pay you for. You understand? He wants you to have the same mindset he have, be able to push it to your people. You understand? Automatically, now you teach Jake how to think, it become dangerous to society. That's why growing up, we never had the instructions. We never had nowhere to go. Then they claim they were black men. We had father figure. That didn't teach us nothing. They have father figure. They didn't teach them nothing. So America was okay as long that nobody came to tell Jake how to change. You understand? You have to change. He was okay with it. Dr. King in the picture in the West. When they don't come with the vision the Lord want us to push on this earth, Israel, you have to change. The power come within you changing. Now, the white men never want that. But that's what the 144 is there for. That's our job, to teach our people how to think. You've been set up. That's why the bishop went in many class, is to break the trap that been set for us and showing us the trap. Have you ever seen when the army going on, they call it mine, that little mine thing they set up. When you touch it, you blow up. Yeah, like a minefield. America is a minefield. The bishop is here to tell you where every minefield is. Then it's up to you. You might say, it's nothing there. I don't see nothing. Why would he be in the class about? Then your mind, you might think that. But it's really what's going on. America set this trap for us. You understand? Then he paid people to set this trap. Then believe it or not, they're all getting higher pay. When you see the white man, he living in the hill. He don't have a job. He's inside the house almost 20 hours a day. What you think he's doing? He's thinking for America.
Now get that in Leviticus 26:17, please.
Leviticus 26:17. And I will set my face against you, and ye shall be slain before your enemies. They that hate you shall reign over you.
Y'all see that? They that hate you shall reign over you. You can't get no more heavier than that. God is telling us the people that hate you will rule over you. But you know what happens with us? We will meet Edomites. Everybody up in here know what I'm about to say. We cannot, like, remember what I'm going to, okay, so no one gets offended. And I'll use Malcolm X as an example. Remember in the movie that Spike Lee did, remember the white girl came up and she said, "What can I do?" He said nothing. But then when he got confounded because of the BS with Elijah Muhammad, he started thinking back on certain white people that he came across that was somewhat decent or quote unquote good. And it was messing his mind up. Now, how does that apply to us in here today? The Most High. Give me that scripture. When a man's ways please the Lord. Give me that one. I don't know where it is. Somebody help me. I know it's in Proverbs, but I don't remember where. 16 verse 7. Thank you. Get that for me. I'm going to show y'all because some of y'all get messed up in the head.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 16 and verse 7. When a man's ways please the Lord, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace with him.
Now, I'm glad you stressed the right word this time. You see the word he used is, it said enemies. Is that the word you read?
Yes, yes, sir.
It didn't say friend.
Enemies.
What happens is white, certain Caucasians, Edomites, we got to get used to saying that, Edomites, will say, hey, Bob, I'm going to give you a job and pay you $40,000 a year. You've been making $20,000. Now, this, to, in your mind, wow, $40,000. Yes. And I'm going to put you up in this nice house over here, and I'll give you a car to drive. Like, y'all see that house? What's this show where your house is dilapidated and a truck come by and fix your house? What's the name of that show? Extreme Makeover. Or you see black women who be all jacked up in the face, and a white man said, let me fix your face. And she come out all lovely. Or her, I saw one black woman, her butt was flat. And a white man said, let me give you a butt. I'm going to hook you up. And her butt was like, Shazam, bam! And you got to think, in their minds, I was sitting, I'm looking at these silly shows and the wife. I said, do you think these recipients of these rewards will ever accept this truth? You tell them that they are your enemies, they'll be like, oh, hell no! This white man just fixed my house. Look at, and you know they put TV monitors all in there, new refrigerators, and they get a new car. Our people be, oh, wow. No, you wrong. You a nigga devil yourself. That's what they'll say to us.
Dick and I thought you could attest to that. The man just bought him ice cream.
Oh, that. Oh yeah, the Edomite bought you ice cream at camp.
Bought ice cream to niggas.
Edomite came up. Called him a devil. He said, oh, okay, I'm a devil. He went away by ice cream and started cursing us out. All of Jake's cursing us out. He hugging him and all of that stuff.
Right, I saw that video.
He didn't give him a house or a car or a job or nothing. Just gave him ice cream. Damn, that was...
And they all cursed you out. All of Jake started cursing him out. You know, you know what? Give me that. Exodus 23. Is that what I want? No. Ecclesiastes 7 about a gift. 7 and 7. Give me that one. Give me that. So God says, when your ways please the Lord, he will make even your enemies at peace with you. But the key word to remember is they are your enemies. We say, no, because they did something good to us, they are friends. The word didn't change. Right. The word didn't change in the Bible. You're not going to, it does not matter. Come on, Cap.
Ecclesiastes 7 and 7. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad. And the gift destroyeth the heart.
Y'all see that? The gift destroyeth the heart. So when he fixes up our homes, our houses, reduces our mortgage, reduces our interest, whatever he does that is so good for us. Give us ice cream. Thank you. Give us ice cream. We start to dance and jig, and he good. And he's Santa Claus, and you're Swart the Pete. Yeah.
Look at the... Section 8, welfare system, housing. Look at all these things he give our people. You really think our people will go against that, man? Then looking at it, especially when they get to the black woman. Free college. You understand? You can be whatever you want. You think when they heard these words, they'll repent, brother?
I'll give you an example of a think tank. You have WIC. You know what WIC stands for? Women, infants, and children. It's not FWIC, as in father. It's women, infants, and children. That's what it's geared towards. Another one is the feminist movement. That's another think tank where they take the sisters and tell them, yeah, your man's oppressing you. We haven't oppressed the black woman since we bought the ships. We have no control over them at all. But they thought that they need liberation and freedom from us. What freedom and liberation from us? We are both slaves together. That's the way to keep us divided. That's the think tank that was involved in that also. That was Gloria Steinem and Mamilla Bloomer. And other sisters, all those women's suffrage movement, they all infiltrated the abolitionist movements during the years and made the slave liberation man and wife liberation. They try to say, oh, we're suffering too. Our husbands are mean to us. We're suffering like the slaves are. And try to make it an equal struggle. And that's what they did to this day. They're doing the same thing to this day. Same exact thing.
Yes. Oh, those shows are fake? Oh, are they? The house falls down? Yeah. Jonas says the house is fake. He said it, after the show, they take the TVs out and take everything out the house. That'd be fun if they do that. But the one with the black woman with the butt was real. They gave her a real butt. I don't know what they put in there. There's some kind of silicone. I said, what the hell? Where we at, Captain? Y'all was sidetracking me. Where we at? Come on, Cap.
Ecclesiastes 7:7. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
Surely oppression makes a wise man mad. Go ahead.
And a gift destroyeth the heart.
And a gift destroyeth the heart. Give me Deuteronomy 28:49-50 about our enemies. This is the spirit God said is upon our enemies. Now we just read, those that hate you shall reign over you. Didn't we just read that? Watch what Moses said here in Deuteronomy 28:49-50.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flyeth.
And their symbol is the eagle, starting with Spain. Even now in America, the symbol is the eagle. Go ahead.
A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand.
He spoke Spanish, and now we speak American English. Go ahead.
A nation of fierce countenance.
A nation of fierce countenance. Come on.
Which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young.
Stop. Now, in your mind, you may say, well, that was back then when Rome conquered Jerusalem. Oh, really? So during the, I'll just jump closer up to the 60s. When they were sicking the dogs, it wasn't just biting the grown men. It was women and children and old folks. When they put those water hoses on us, it wasn't just the men. It was women and children and old folks. When they was lynching us, it was not just the men. It was women and children and old folk. Can you read that again? Because some of y'all like to keep the Bible back. We just read, I'm going to show you how smart the white man is. What did we just read in Theos? You cannot understand the modern world without understanding religion or the Bible. That's what the white theology people said. They know that. But our people are so, no, that's back then, brother. You just keep that Bible back then. You're a fool. You're an idiot. In order to understand a modern world, you must understand this. God, give us the personality, the characteristics of them again. One more time.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flyeth. A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand. A nation of fierce countenance.
Y'all see that? Go ahead.
Which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young.
Y'all see that? So that was for back then as well as the modern world today. They're just, what we just saw with Bill Gates. You think those his plan for world population is just for adults? No. He's kill the kids, kill, euthanize the old. That world population, he said, use vaccines. What else he said? Healthcare, reproductive health services. That's just not, that's for all of us, whether it's old or young. Everybody understand that? Let me confuse you. Now, get me Habakkuk chapter 2, and I think it's either 4 or 5, about his soul, that one. 2 and 4, thank you. Give me that one. I'm shooting from the hip. I ain't went over these in a while. I got to touch them again. I'm telling y'all, be asleep because the man smiles in our face, gives us jobs and money. He got a homeless brother. White man give him $10. He said, oh, thank Jesus. Come on.
Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 4. Behold, his soul which is lifted up is not upright in him.
So why do black men and black women think we can change? I have a good white friend. God's, read it again. If you don't believe me, you should at least believe the creator. Read it again.
Behold, his soul, which is lifted up, is not upright in him.
When it says his soul, which is lifted up how? He lifted up himself as God, Christ, the angels, and you. He has taken your position in society. He said, we the Israelites. We the Christians. You don't know who you niggas and spicks are. That's how they do us.
Bishop, they missed the word that was read in that verse. Read that verse again.
Behold, his soul which is lifted up.
Stop. His soul. That's the part y'all missed. The soul meaning the essence of them. You cannot change the base of them. That's what that scripture is saying. Read it again.
Behold, his soul, which is lifted up, is not upright in him.
God is saying that he's a natural born killer. That's what the Bible says. That's what it's saying. His soul is wicked.
You don't, y'all don't see some, I don't like to say this, but just in my mind, I think I should say it. You ever look at some of them in the eyes? They'll look like animal eyes. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't say that.
You ain't the only one. I see that all the time. I said, these people ain't far from a wolf.
I'm like, maybe I shouldn't say that, but I see it. I'll be looking at them like, what the hell is wrong with you? You got the devil on you. I want to check their head for 3 sixes, too. No, I'm just joking. Get me a scripture in 1 Esdras 5:66. I like this one. 1 Esdras 5. We're still talking about genocide. We didn't change the topic. So again, Bill Gates. Remember, syphilis was a conspiracy to kill us off. Tuskegee experiment. Okay, syphilis, HIV, AIDS, Ebola, Zika. That is what Bill Gates was talking about. Okay.
Years ago, there was a video that we had way back. I forget this Edomite's name, Andrew Strecker, something to that effect. I can't remember exactly. Where he showed that the AIDS virus is, in fact, a made virus. Mm-hmm. That they actually made it.
Right. I saw that. Yeah. We had that Center video. Of Disease Control, yep. CDC. Yep, exactly. And you know what? You can purchase, there's a Zika strain when you go to Amazon.com. If you are medically affiliated or scientifically affiliated, you can buy a low strain of the Zika virus for $5. I said, they already got, show you the day the devil, they've been known about this. And there's a patent on it from the Rockefeller Foundation from 1947. Wow. So don't think Zika is new. White man said, now is the time to send it out. Time is getting short. Where did I say go? 1 Esdras 5:66.
1 Esdras 5:66. Wherefore, when the enemies of the tribe of Judah and Benjamin heard it, they came to know what that noise of trumpets should mean. And they perceived that they that were of the captivity did build the temple unto the Lord God of Israel. So they went to Zerubbabel and Jesus and to the chief of the families and said unto them, we will build together with you, for we likewise as ye do obey your Lord and do sacrifice unto him from the days of Asbazareth.
So these were converts. A lot of times people say, well, what about converts of other nations? Watch what our forefathers said about the converts. Go ahead.
The king of the Assyrians who brought us hither, then Zerubbabel and Jesus and the chief of the families of Israel said unto them, it is not for us and you to build together in house unto the Lord our God. We ourselves alone will build unto the Lord of Israel, according as Cyrus the king of the Persians hath commanded us.
See, our forefathers did not say, because you are a convert. Now, hold that. Hold this real quick. Let me show you another one. Give me Esther. It might be chapter 9 and 15, I'm guessing. Esther, where it said they converted. Is it 8? Show me that. Somebody show me that.
8:17.
Thank you. Watch this.
And in every province and in every city, whithersoever the king's commandment and his decree came, the Jews had joy and gladness, a feast and a good day, and many of the people of the land became Jews, for the fear of the Jews fell upon them.
So many of the other nations converted to become and followed our customs because they feared us, because we had rule under Esther and Mordecai to put them to death. So today, like I was listening to a debate with that guy, Rabbi Schwitz. He ain't no rabbi, but you know what I'm talking about? He kept, quote, you know what I'm talking about, Captain Isaac? Yes, he kept referring to this. Like that, because they converted, that meant something. It means nothing. Mm-hmm. That's what our forefathers, Zerubbabel and Joshua, which is pronounced Jesus now, said. Go back now to 1 Ezra, what he said again.
1 Ezra 5:70. Then Zerubbabel and Jesus and the chief of the families of Israel said unto them, it is not for us and you to build together an house unto the Lord our God. We ourselves alone will build unto the Lord of Israel, according as Cyrus the king of the Persians hath commanded us.
Right. Now, hold on. Wait. Let me look at something real quick. I just want to go to Ezra in the Bible. All right, look at Ezra. Go to regular Bible. Ezra 4, the same story. Verse 3. The wording is more harsh. I like the way it's worded here. It's the same history.
Ezra chapter 4 and verse 3. But Zerubbabel and Jeshua and the rest of the chief of the fathers of Israel said unto them, ye have nothing to do with us.
Stop. You see how harsh that is? You have nothing to do with us. You converts, you have nothing to do with us. It wasn't, oh, you're a convert? Come, join us. No, no. Our forefathers, as we read down, you're going to see why they were so smart and did not allow themselves to be infiltrated. Read.
You have nothing to do with us to build an house unto our God, but we ourselves together will build unto the Lord God of Israel, as King Cyrus, the king of Persia, hath commanded us.
Go back now to 1 Ezra chapter 5, same history again. See, when y'all read, you got to look at both and go back and forth and look at the different wordings.
1 Ezra 5 and 70. Then Zerubbabel and Jesus and the chief of the families of Israel said unto them, it is not for us and you to build together in house unto the Lord our God.
There's no together in this. Go ahead.
We ourselves alone will build unto the Lord of Israel, according as Cyrus the king of the Persians hath commanded us.
Watch this.
But the heathen of the land, lying heavy upon the inhabitants of Judea and holding them straight, hindered their building.
They hindered their building. Watch this.
And by their secret plots.
And by their secret plots. Go ahead. Conspiracies. These are conspiracies. Think tanks. Go ahead.
And popular persuasions and commotions. They hindered the finishing of the building all the time that King Cyrus lived. So they were hindered from building for the space of 2 years until the reign of Darius.
So that's what the converts did. These converts said, we're going to hinder their building. We can't infiltrate them. Let's hinder their building.
And what's heavy is they say, we ourselves alone. That alone means we don't need you.
Right.
As they told them, we don't need your help. We're good. Get out of here.
Exactly. Now, watch this. Get me Judith. Y'all, so you're going to say something.
What you just read was super heavy because I'm thinking about what was read in the context of the class that you're bringing out concerning think tanks. The think tanks are so, the effects of the think tank is so heavy on our people that we would hear stuff like what he was reading, like those statements, those hard statements that was being read. Some of us are uncomfortable hearing that. I know nobody's going to admit to it, but they are uncomfortable. In other words, they say, why is it saying so plain like that? So what? Let them help us. Not understanding the reason why we're telling them not to. Because we understood that all nations are for their own people. They cannot be for their own people and you. That's just a natural law. Our people understood that. But today, because of the effects of the think tank, we don't think like that.
Exactly.
And that's what the problem is. Go ahead.
Because, Bishop, that's the same way we teach in the street. This don't have nothing to do with you.
Right.
Can we teach our people, please?
Right. And they think you're being racist.
Yeah, that thing you're being racist.
Right. Give me the book of Judith, chapter 5. Judith, chapter 5. And I want verse 20 and 21.
Judith, chapter 5 and verse 20. Now, therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people.
Now, many of you brothers and sisters may have never read the history of Judith. What happened is you had a king or a general? Holofernes. He was a general. He wanted to fight, and he wanted the nations to stand by him. And he said, whichever nation does not support him in his military campaign, he will come back and destroy you when he wins. Our forefathers did not join him in his military campaign. So now he comes back and he inquires of his men in his military. He asked them, who is the people that lives in the hill country? He said, give me their history. I want to know their history on them. Now read it, start again, Captain Isaac.
Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people.
Meaning the Israelites. He's telling them, if there be any error, meaning sin in the Israelites. Go ahead.
And they sin against their God. Let us consider that this shall be their ruin.
This shall be their ruin, their destruction. Go ahead.
And let us go up, and we shall overcome them.
Let us go up. We can go overcome them. We can destroy them in battle. Go ahead.
But,
listen to this.
If there be no iniquity in their nation.
If these people are keeping God's commandments. Go ahead.
Let my Lord now pass by.
You better leave them to hell alone. Go ahead.
Lest their Lord defend them.
Lest God defends them.
And their God be for them. And we become a reproach before all the world.
And we become mud on all the earth.
I got to say something. Could you read that scripture again? There's a word that we, when we read this scripture, we never really focus on it. I want to focus on it for just a second. Read it again. Now, this is in relation to the subject on think tanks. I gave you a hint already. Read it.
Now, therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people, and they sin against their God, let us consider.
Stop. What does that word consider mean? Contemplate deeply. So they have to think of ways on how to cause our people to sin. And that's where all of these different political systems, our religious system, education, music, all of the things that we read earlier that was part of the think tank, all of these things came about through careful consideration on causing our people to sin. Read that again and then give it back to the bishop.
Now, therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people.
If there be any error, so the subject matter is about causing error in us. Go ahead.
And they sin against their God.
So the error is the sin. Go ahead.
Let us consider.
Let us think deep. Let us concentrate. Let us think about it deeply. Think tank. Go ahead.
That this shall be their ruin.
And that is the purpose of their think tank, is to ruin us.
Watch this. Go back to Theos now. Hold that cap. We're going right back to Theos, because I know y'all forgot already. Theos. Go right back. Look at the first sentence. Thank you, Officer Renan, for sending this. Theos is a Christian think tank which believes you can't understand the modern world without understanding religion, meaning the Bible. So you mean to tell me these people don't know who the 12 tribes of Israel are? You better believe they do. You mean to tell me that they've never read the book of Judith? That if you keep the Israelites in sin, we can keep ruling? You better believe they've done their research already. It's us. We're the ones clueless. But now we're coming out of the darkness saying, you know what? So all the things that we've discussed, like the think tanks, the cultural, the social, political think tanks, all these things is meant, guess what, brothers and sisters, to keep us all in sin. Some sisters will always say, what's wrong with us wearing pants? There's a lot of things wrong with it. It keeps us in sin. The nations know, keep them in sin. And guess, like you said, some black women have joined the feminist movement and said, black men have oppressed us. And the good point you made, black men have never been able to control the black woman. Ever. Now you might say, I ain't talking about the nigga that beats a woman in the head, like in The Help. You saw the movie The Help? Why they had that in the movie? I don't know what that had to do with it. But they put that, even in the Whoopi Goldberg movie, Color Purple. That's to play with our heads. But again, the black and Latin man has never been able to control the black and Latin woman. They do what they want to do. They run the house. Am I right or wrong? We've never been able to control them. It's now that we're learning the Bible. Listen, the scriptures say do this and do that. This is what you women have to do. Then you get the woman, but what's wrong with it? God ain't going to destroy me because I dress like a man. You keeping us at the bottom of society because you dress like a man. The hell is this? We're trying to raise up now. Here come the woman. But come down, come down. What is this God stuff?
Right, and as far as control goes, because if the point is about, well, I don't want no man controlling me, she's being controlled by the white man.
There you go.
Because that's who she's following. She's following, so I always say, she's going to follow some man.
Yo, what's up? A think tank. Thank you. Sat down and said, how can we get in their head?
Exactly.
Give them wick, give them free food, free housing. They will do whatever we say. Give him 911 when a man get out of order.
I know that was. I know that when
a think tank.
Right, exactly. If you don't think that when I say that, there's always an image of a man in the woman's mind. If it just ain't you, it ain't our people. Not from I'm saying in general. It just ain't us. But there's an image. Look how she would raise her children. Her children will be raised in the image of the white man, will be raised in the image of the man she adores, will be raised in the image of the man she looks up to who she respects.
Right. Let's go deeper. Let's go deeper. If women can wear pants, Esau thinks ahead. He knows if we can let women wear pants. Remember, it was this woman that started. Women said we always wear. They had a thing called the Victorian era. Women wore corsets. They wore like layers upon layers upon layers of clothes. So they're mad. All they got to wear these clothes is so heavy. So they complained about it. And over time, the white woman got the liberty to wear pants. Then she told the black woman the same thing. But Esau realized, well, if we let them wear pants, over time, if we want, we can let the men wear dresses. We can slip it in. We have modest pants for women. We'll make masculine skirts for men. Look at Will Smith's son. Jaden Smith is now modeling the female Louis Vuitton line. Let's wearing a skirt. Show the pictures. You can Google it. Where he's wearing, you had Jamie Foxx do it. Will Smith started to do it. Martin Lawrence doing
Kanye
it.
Kanye West.
Kanye West. What's that guy? That comedian that started it first, that Jake. Right. Damn, the old school comedian started it.
Flip Wilson.
Flip Wilson started this. Started with him. He sparked it off.
You better get him, sucker.
I remember that.
There you go, Geraldine. Right there.
That's Will Smith.
When they asked him, he said, "Oh, my son has the right to express himself." I tell him to express himself. Hey, he's expressing his homosexuality. That's what he's expressing. Or effeminate. I'll say that. I won't say he's homosexual, but effeminate. That's homosexual.
Right. And because most black people, what? Hey, watch this. What better person to use than Will Smith's son? Most everybody loves Will Smith.
Go to his daughter. See how she looks. Watch the difference. Willow Smith. See how she dresses. Look how she, go to images. Look how she's dressing. Look at the complete, right there with the white shirt. Look at the difference. It's like it switched places. That's Willie Lynch raising them in reverse roles. It's the same thing side by side. So when you hear Jake say things like, oh, they have modest pants for females, then we can say, oh, they have modest skirts for males then. You got flipped both sides of the coin. Exactly. Either one or the other, or not at all. And exactly. The law says not at all.
Exactly. Now remember this. Remember what we read earlier about think tanks, and there was one called Culture. Yep. And don't think that he got this on his own notion. I'm going to dress like a woman or her. I'm going to dress like a man. They made it socially acceptable. Remember the dude Aaron Magruder? Boondocks.
Boondocks.
He told everybody what was about to happen. What was the name of that rapper? Gangstalicious. He made a clothing. Google that.
An effeminate clothing line for men. Where you carry a purse and you wear a skirt.
Remember back in the day, I don't know about some of you young ones, but Ace of you might remember. Remember the gay dudes would tie their shirt in a knot?
In a knot, yes.
Look at it. I don't know if y'all remember that back in the. Hananai, you know what I'm talking about. That was some nasty stuff. But they made it fashion now. Now, Aaron Magruder did it as a joke, but he was telling everybody what was about to happen. Yeah, he knew because he was sitting in some of those meetings with BET. Remember BET fired him? Because he was revealing how wicked they was. And they fired, took his whole thing off. Can we read that again in Judith 5? I want y'all to see how relevant the Bible is.
Judith chapter 5 and verse 20. Now, therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people, and they sin against their God, let us consider that this shall be their ruin.
So, society knows that. The leaders of society understand that scripture. That's why I don't think these fashion things are by accident. It's nothing is by accident. It's all crafty design, like we read in Psalms 83, verse 3 and 4.
Bishop, you made such a magnificent point of putting emphasis on the woman being in opposition to the rebuilding of the nation. And I'm going to show you in the scriptures that That was anticipated. That's why this had to be written in the scriptures, because a lot of sisters get mad at this scripture here. The bishop just pointed out that the nations know if we're in sin, the Most High won't deliver us. We will be in ruins as a nation. The nations of the Most High knows, because it's in their spirit for the woman 9 times out of 10 to be in opposition to us. Go to 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 11. That's why this is written. This is to combat their opposition to us.
1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 11. Let the woman learn in silence with all subjection.
Because they hate that scripture. They hate that scripture. But because of what the bishop pointed out about the woman insisting, I want to wear pants, insisting, I want to put blonde in my hair, insisting, I want to have my breasts out, I want to dress in a way that's provocative. It was already seen in their spirit that they were going to go against the rebuilding of the nation. So it's written, read it again.
Let the woman learn in silence with all subjection.
Meaning whatever the Bible says to do, if you believe in God the way you say, you will keep your mouth shut and be in subjection to the word of the Most High. Read on.
But I suffer not a woman to teach.
Because what they're going to teach, that there's women's pants. They're going to go into a long argument saying that there's women's pants. A long argument about why they want to wear blonde hair, why they don't want to cover their hair. Okay? Why they can't be with any man they want to be with. Or why marriage? Read on.
Nor to usurp authority over the man.
Because the number one problem that you have with the rebuilding of the nation is the woman trying to be on the same level with the man. Read on.
But to be in silence.
So what you gotta ask, why was this written here? Because they say to themselves, I have a voice, I want to be heard. Don't tell me to be quiet. The reason why it's put in the scriptures for them to be quiet is because this world has programmed them to be against God and against the men that are trying to rebuild this nation. So the next time you get questioned on this scripture here, which y'all always going to get it from the woman, you see why. Read on.
For Adam was first formed, then Eve, and Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in the transgression.
That's everything that the bishop just put out with the TV, with the magazines, with the politicians, with the laws being passed. Satan is coming at them the same way he came at them in the garden. The only difference is he's using all the forces that we wrestle against in high places to keep them down, to deceive them in believing that freedom to do these things against the Most High will not prohibit them from being the kind of woman they want to be. That's why the scripture said, let them just stay quiet and learn in subjection and not argue. Because the same way Eve was deceived when she felt she had power to do whatever she want, you woman now will be deceived also if power is given to you to do what you want. Read on.
Notwithstanding, she shall be saved.
So there are some that are going to be saved. Read on.
In childbearing, if they continue in faith.
If what?
If they continue in faith.
Say it one more time.
If they continue in faith.
The faith is that we have the resolution to rebuilding our nation. Don't argue with us. Don't beat us down. Ask, what can I do to help you men? Continue in faith that what we're doing is going to benefit you in the long run and not your own selfish feelings the way Eve was in the garden. Read on.
And charity.
And charity. Okay, doing what the scriptures say to do, helping us as we try to rebuild. Read on.
And holiness with sobriety.
Sobriety meaning you in your right mind. And the TV hasn't poisoned your mind. YouTube hasn't poisoned your mind. Oprah hasn't poisoned your mind. Because a lot of sisters that are in opposition, like Deacon Yawasab said, there is a man inside their head. It's just not the Most High. It's not his son, and it's not us. The same way Satan got in the garden is the same way it's going to be right now.
From there, let's go to Psalms 10. Psalms 10. I'm going to jump through this. Read verse 1 and 2.
Psalms chapter 10, verse 1. Why standest thou afar off, O Lord? Why hidest thou thyself in times of trouble?
Go ahead.
The wicked in his pride doth persecute the poor.
Stop. Who is the wicked? Somebody raise your hand and I want a scripture. Somebody raise your hand. I want a scripture. Okay, you with the black IUIC shirt. Yeah, you. Who is the wicked? I want a scripture.
Malachi 1 and 4, Esau.
Yes, let's get that sure. Cap. This is for the new people. Because you read wicked and the first thing you're thinking of is your brother. But it's talking about Esau, the nation of Edom.
Malachi chapter 1 and verse 4. Whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness.
Y'all see what the Bible says about Esau, which is Edom? The border of wickedness. Go back now to Psalms 10. Watch what it says about them.
Psalms 10 and verse 2.
I want, jump down to verse 8.
Verse 8. He sitteth in the lurking places of the villages.
Talking about the wicked, Esau. Watch what he does.
In the secret places doth he murder the innocent. His eyes are privily set against the poor.
Y'all know what the word privily means? Secretly. His eyes, it said his eyes are what? Secretly set against the poor. God is letting us know they are always plotting, always planning against. We're the poor. And it don't mean poor financially. It's talking about poor spiritually. Because we've forgotten our identity, nationality, our culture, our heritage. That's what makes us the poor. When Christ talks, says about blessed are the poor, for theirs are the kingdom of heaven. Remember, you had rich Israelites like Nicodemus, Zacchaeus, Joseph of Arimathea. What made them poor? We were in subjection under Rome. And we were about to lose everything when 70 AD came. Here we are today. We have lost everything. We are the poor, the Bible speaks of, that the wicked set their eyes secretly against.
Never want to speak on.
Bishop.
Secretly desire, secretly seeking to destroy the poor, right? That's what you were saying. We just saw an example of that in the beginning of the video. Secretly meaning that you don't know his true intention. It's talking about Bill Gates. Let's use him for an example. His title is a what? Philanthropist. So, and what did we read about philanthropy? Giving of doing good services to people and such. But secretly, he's endorsing eugenics. Endorsing abortion, population abatement, and things like this here. And health things and all that stuff that we was going over. Secretly. You love him, but he's out to kill you.
Now, what we saw the cartoon with Boondocks, they showed, like, remember we joked earlier about how these think tanks, they will hire the dumbest, most illiterate rapper they can. They did as a joke, but that is the reality with the Boondocks.
That's why I was
laughing. They find a popular rapper and say, if you push cross-dressing, they'll all follow because they love you, right? That's what he did it as a joke, but that is the reality behind it. There was a think tank that said, hire somebody like that gangsta-licious. Everybody loves him. Give me Job chapter 5 and 12. Start at 11.
The book of Job, chapter 5 and verse 11. To set up on high those that be low.
So the Most High's plan is to set us Israelites up on high. We are the low. It says to set up on high those that be low. So God's plan is to set us up as the rulers on the earth under Christ. Go ahead.
That those which mourn may be exalted to safety.
We're the ones that mourn. He wants to bring us to safety. That's his plan. Go ahead.
He disappointeth the devices of the craft.
So all the think tanks, brothers and sisters, no matter how clever, how crafty, the prophecy says he disappoints them. Read that part again.
He disappointeth the devices of the craft.
Let me ask this question. What is one of the main ways the Most High disappoints the devices of the crafty? What is one of the main ways? In the back, brother with glasses.
Shalom.
Shalom.
The Bible.
Yes, the Bible. Hold that. Give me that in Thessalonians. You know what I want? Consume them. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. Look around 7, 8, 9, about to consume them. It says that. Somebody help Isaac.
I got it.
Okay.
Verse 8. 2 Thessalonians 2, verse 8. And then shall that wicked be revealed.
Through the Bible.
Whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth.
What is the spirit of God's mouth, brothers? The Bible. guess what? God ain't coming down here teaching for you, but he will come down and teach through you. That's what he does. When you are speak, that's why, like Asa was saying, your words must remain in the Bible. Don't come up with your own words. That's why I get mad when I talk too long. I got to get back to the scriptures. Because you start talking your own talk. Get back to the power is in the Bible, brothers.
Or Bishop, or they turn into those other Israelite groups that have not evolved, and they spend 3 hours talking about what the white man did to them. This is a big Bible, and you should be able to go in there and use the Bible to build your people up and bring them to righteousness.
Exactly. Go back to Job 5 now. So God's plan is to consume them with the spirit of his mouth, which is the Bible. Back to Job 5 and 12.
Job 5 verse 12. He disappointeth the devices of the crafty.
So all their plots, like we were talking about the feminist movement, that's a plot. We were talking about the economics, that's a plot. Social, political movement, that's a plot. But guess, Planned Parenthood, everything we've discussed, the Bible discusses too and gives us solutions. Go ahead.
So that their hands cannot perform their enterprise.
So if you spend, if you brothers, that, how many of your brothers in here teach the Bible? Raise your hand. Let me hear. Let me see. So if you brothers that teach, if your whole conversation, every teaching is the white man is the devil, there's something wrong with you. There's something spiritually wrong with you because you have no solutions. Okay, the white man is the devil. Now what?
Right. They're spiritually discerned. Bishop. And not only that, the microchip. If you telling your whole entire camp to make 50 videos about the microchip, it's just what the bishop said. You have no solutions for your people. Because why are you going to continue to keep scaring them about a microchip? You should be reading the scripture that the bishop just pulled. The Most High is going to disappoint the devices of the crafty so that they cannot perform their enterprise. So we don't worry about those things. We don't worry about Illuminati or secret societies or all this other stuff that we're doing. We don't care. Exactly. We will make you aware, but we don't care. Exactly. Because a lot of people complain that we're not going into that stuff. Let the white man keep doing that.
Exactly. And another thing about a think tank. They have, do y'all not realize that they have what's called contingency plans? There's a plan A, a plan B, plan C, D, E, F. So if plan A fails, go to plan B. If plan B fails, go to plan C. That's how, and them think tanks will have sometimes 100 people. They have self, so why are you bugging out? Look, the King Alfred, what's the name of that stupid?
Alfred plan.
The King Alfred plan.
That's Jane Helm.
Jane Helm.
The hysteria they spread with Jane Helm.
Right.
Some idiot cop was saying that by summer, when was it? September is from July to September, all the Kmarts are going to be closed and y'all going to be in concentration camps. And we had wicked people coming on to our class ask why we're not talking about that. And all I did was tell them delete their account.
Exactly.
We ain't talking about that here.
Exactly.
Okay? Because they watching the conspiracy stuff from Esau because they don't know the Bible and they bringing that here. And they know black people like to be dazzled with foolishness. So that's how they get their little 50, 60 views.
Yeah, listen. He's scared to go to Kmart now, huh?
Exactly. Yeah, people scared to go to Kmart.
You know, like if Walmart closed down, how I'm going to get my TV?
So go back to Job 5 one more time. Come on.
Job 5, verse 13. Verse 12. He disappointed the devices of the crafty.
Remember we read early in Psalms 83. It used the same word. Remember verse 4? It says what?
Psalms 83 and verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
Y'all see that? Crafty counsel against thy people. Now go back to Job now. Job 5 and 12.
Job 5 and 12. He disappointeth the devices of the crafty.
Y'all see that? Same thing. Go ahead.
So that their hands cannot perform their enterprise.
So God is telling us, don't worry about it. Don't stress yourselves researching all these conspiracies that you have no power to change.
Exactly.
What you got? It's Psalms 33, verse 10. Psalms 33 and verse 10. Explains who the crafty are. And it goes in conjunction with Psalms 83.
Psalms 33 and verse 10. The Lord bringeth the counsel of the heathen to naught.
So the crafty are the heathen. That's what it's referring to. Psalms 83. Go ahead.
He maketh the devices of the people of none effect.
So we're not scared of chip stuff.
Exactly.
I'm not.
Not even a chip. We're not afraid. I'm not afraid of HIV. I'm not afraid of Ebola. I'm not afraid of Zika or whatever the hell. My baby head ain't shrinking. Listen, you keep the commandments of the Most High. There you go, right there. The protection is there. If we obey his laws, like, fuck it, thou shalt not commit adultery. If we apply that law, what you scared about HIV for? What are you afraid of your baby? Because they said now it's sexually transmitted.
Yes.
What if you obeying them laws,
right,
why are you afraid your baby come out with a miniature-sized golf head?
The Most High said he going to plague the wicked. The wicked. So the wicked are going to be the ones speaking in fear all the time. That's why I don't entertain them or stay on the phone with them. When they call with that stuff, I'm like, this is not for you. There are other Israelite camps that you can join that will keep you in fear because they wicked.
Right.
So that's what they sit back worried about every single day because they wicked. They're not keeping no commandments. So they're studying the white man to say, what is he going to do to me next? Like the bishop said, we ain't scared. We're not worried about it because we know the Most High got us.
Exactly, exactly. Get Psalm 64. We're almost done. And guess what? Let me say this. Even if, let's say so they start assassinating us one by one, it means nothing, brother. They start me. Pow! Take that nigga out. This, brothers, sisters, this truth ain't stopping. God prophesied 144,000 leaders, and it is coming to what we see here. This is just a drop in the bucket. He said 12,000 of each tribe. This ain't 12,000 of each tribe. The ones online ain't 12,000. So don't be scared, brothers or sisters. Don't be scared. This, whoever get killed, we rising first.
Bishop, Bishop, the scriptures say exactly what the bishop just said. Was not Isaiah hiding in a cave for his life because they started killing
Elijah,
killing off all the prophets? And did not Paul remind us of that and say just what the bishop said? Don't worry about this. I got 7,000 men on reserves that will not bow the knee. So we ain't worried about getting smoked or dying or whatever. Okay? It was in the Old Testament and the New Testament, it was brought up. If don't worry about who you can't see or who dies. The Most High said, I got men on reserves that will not bow down. So those other men that talk about that foolishness, they're fearful and they wicked. You shall know them by their fruits. That's why all they keep talking about is microchipping conspiracy theories.
Right. I got something for that. Get 2 Esdras 8 and 27. That's what I wanted to get. 2 Esdras 8 and 27.
2 Esdras chapter 8 and verse 27. Mm-hmm. And whosoever is delivered.
No, 2 Esdras 8, 27.
Regard not the wicked inventions of the heathen.
Read it again.
Regard not the wicked inventions of the heathen.
The Lord told Ezra to tell us to regard not. The wicked invent means do not care about that stuff. That's what the Bible says. It's not us speaking out of emotions. It's not just us talking because we want to sound like we're killers.
Right.
Or gangster.
Word is fearless.
Read again.
Regard not the wicked inventions of the heathen.
But do what?
But the desire of those that keep thy testimonies in affliction.
We regard that instead. Regard those that keep the commandments while they're in captivity.
Get that Psalm 64, we almost done, 1 through 5.
Psalm 64 and verse 1. Hear my voice, O God, in my prayer. Preserve my life from fear of the enemy.
See that? Preserve my life from fear of the enemy. Go ahead.
Hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked.
See that? Hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked. When you keep the commandments, you men, you women, you sons and daughters, God said he will. Read that again.
Hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked.
You don't got to worry about syphilis, Ebola, Zika. What are some other things they got out there? Little heads and little testes. I don't know what the hell they got out there.
Bishop, they keep saying that you ain't going to have no foods. There's going to be a food shortage.
Right.
Y'all ain't going to. They said they're telling Israelites you're going to be starving.
Right. You ain't got to worry about that stuff. God always has a plan for his people. Come on.
From the insurrection of the workers of iniquity.
From the insurrection from the workers of iniquity. Come on.
Who wet their tongue like a sword and bend their bows to shoot their arrows.
When it says they wet their tongue like a sword, meaning they're always speaking against us. When they call us Negroes, Latinos, that's a sword. Cut because they're saying we're less than dirt. We're nothing. Go ahead.
Even bitter words.
Uh-huh.
That they may shoot in secret at the perfect.
See that? That they may shoot in secret. At the perfect. That's their plots. Go ahead.
Suddenly do they shoot at him and fear not. They encourage themselves in an evil matter.
Right. All of these plots, these conspiracies, all evil matters. Come on.
They commune of laying snares privily.
They commune. They discuss of think tanks of laying traps secretly. These are think tanks, brothers, sisters.
They didn't hear that. Read that again.
They encourage themselves in an evil matter. They commune of laying snares privily.
They encourage all of that. They encourage themselves. Read that statement again.
They commune of laying snares privily. They say, who shall see them? They search out iniquities.
Well, who's the part of that? Well, where's the encouragement? That's the part I want.
They encourage themselves in an evil matter.
They encourage themselves in an evil manner. So that means they get together and they talk about what to do. They encourage, they say, well, my ideas are this, your ideas are that. And they back each other up because their fruition is to destroy Israel. Go ahead.
They commune of laying snares privily.
And they get together and talk about laying traps. And that's what we was reading in them think tank things that we was reading earlier.
So for us to sit around and try to figure out all their various devices, you are simple as hell. You'd be foolish. For one think tank, you might have 100 plans. They you got to read money. And research each one of those things.
They got the money. They got the power. They can switch their plan up at any time.
Exactly.
Any time. You got when the Jade Helm thing didn't happen, they said, oh, they heard us speaking in the street, so they decided not to do it.
Y'all keep listening to these dummies.
Yes. Somebody passed me the video. They said they watching us, and they heard us talking about it. They saw we got 50 views, so they decided don't do it.
What verse was that, Captain Isaac?
Verse 5.
That was 5?
Yes, sir.
Or you finished?
They say, who shall see them? They search out iniquities.
See that? They search out iniquities. Those are think tanks. Remember what we saw with Theos? It said they believe. Go back to that again because we keep forgetting it. Theos, which is Theos is Latin for God. Come on. It says Theos is a Christian think tank which believes, not believes, they know. You can't understand the modern world without understanding religion, meaning the Bible. In order to understand world events, the people of God especially, you got to know the Bible. Read that again.
That ain't talking about no Quran. When they said religion, they are not talking about no Quran. They ain't talking about no Kabbalah. They're talking about the Bible. That's exactly what they're talking about.
Or the Book of the Dead.
They ain't talking about none of that but the Bible. That's exactly what they're talking about. That's clear. That's easy to understand.
Exactly. Read that part.
Verse 5. They encourage themselves in an evil matter. They commune of laying snares privily. They say, who shall see them? They search out iniquities.
Right. And when it says, who shall see them? You know why it says that? It says, for the same reason it says, mystery, Babylon the Great. You know why it says, mystery, Babylon the Great, and why it says, who shall see them? Most of our people, when you tell them, America's Babylon, they say, no. They feed us. They take care of us. No, that's not Babylon, the wicked kingdom.
They give us ice cream.
They give us ice cream. When you say the white man has think tanks to keep us, according to Psalms 83, divided, they go, no. They just built me a house. They gave me a car. They gave me a job.
Bishop, they gave me an Obama phone.
Right, they gave me an Obama phone. So they say, it's not. That's what the white man says. Who sees us? Who will know that we would ever sit down and do such a thing? Why? They portray themselves as God, Christ, Jesus, angels, Israelites, all the righteousness in the world is them. So we would never believe that they are the wicked the Bible speaks of.
Bishop, there was a white dude and his wife living in which area? What he was doing in Africa. He traveled Africa. He was selling the soul. He was selling the kids from Africa. His job was to gather the young girl, 12-year-old, to bring them to older white men. But these guys, you never think he would do something like
exactly.
that. He looked like a regular man, a regular family man. His job is, travel with.
Remember, they were stealing children in Haiti with the Hurricane
child
Katrina.
Child trafficking. Yep. They
was doing that right, child trafficking. You would never believe it. What verse was that, Captain Isaac?
That was verse 6.
Go ahead.
They search out iniquities.
So when it says they search out iniquities, they have think tanks to search. Archaeologists, they have people that sit in a room like this and search scripture upon scripture. Go ahead. Archaeological, go ahead.
They accomplish a diligent search.
Y'all see that? They get paid big money. They accomplish a diligent. They don't, you know how they say about black people? They say we, I got to use the word. They say we half-ass everything. I'm sorry I had to say it, but that's what they say about
us.
Yes. But white people do a diligent search.
Do you miss the big one? If you want to hide something from a black person, put it where? In a book.
Exactly.
Okay, which is the Bible, because black people don't search it out. All you want to do is come to the church and go, hallelujah, praise the Lord, amen. We tell you to read a scripture. Right. We tell you to read a scripture. You start sleeping. Falling asleep.
Yeah.
You like can't sit here. Still.
Some of y'all falling asleep now, right? You got the devil on you.
And what's crazy about what the bishop said, all you have to do is look at the history of the Bible, okay, which they did. They took their time and they diligently we got some sleepers.
It's the heat.
All you have to do is look at the history of the Bible, and it backs everything the bishop said. If you look at from the captivity from Egypt, the Babylonians, the Persians, the Medes, how we switched from hand to hand, why did the Most High move us from captivity after captivity after captivity? Because we wouldn't keep the laws. How hard is it for Esau to look and say, hey, guess what? We know that God loves them, but look here. Each time they went into captivity, they wouldn't keep the laws. So how can we extend our captivity so that we don't run into the same thing the other times when they were delivered? Keep them niggas wicked. Make them hate each other. Tell the woman to keep pants on. Don't cover her head. Put blonde in her hair. Disrespect her husband. Eat pork, shrimp, crab, lobster. And that just took for them to read something you don't want to read. Very simple.
That's heavy. That's some heavy stuff there, y'all. Some heavy stuff. Now, we're almost closing out. We're almost closing out. Give me what I want. Give me Habakkuk 3:14.
Thou didst strike through with his staves the head of his villages.
So in Christ's return, he's going to smite the nations. That's what it's talking about. Go ahead.
They came out as a whirlwind to scatter me.
So the militaries of the world should go out against Christ to scatter him and the angels.
Their rejoicing was as to devour the poor secretly.
See that? So their rejoicing, they rejoice to devour us how?
Secretly.
They will never come out on TV or any newspapers say we hate black people or Latin people. They're not going to do it. It will always be secret. The Bible gives you the answers, brothers and sisters. We have to obey what this book says, believe what this book says, and do what this book says.
Hello, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets up. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.